The story of Jesus from the very beginning was a story of unlikely characters for the welcoming of a king or the welcoming of someone so important into the world. We've had older people, we had a virgin, carpenters, shepherds, and today we hear the story of the Magi, people who come from a different place and a different culture. From the very beginning, the story of the birth of the Savior is about how God has come to all of us. And all of these different people, all of these different characters in the story are an illustration of the ways in which God comes to each one of us. We're also reminded that in each of these cases, every time the angel spoke to them, their life completely changed. They thought they were going in one direction, the angel spoke to them, and then they changed their life. They completely changed where they thought they were going, what they thought they were doing, in order to embrace this message of new life from the angel. And today we hear it again, that the Magi, who embarked on one mission from Herod, which was to find the child and go back and tell King Herod, when they meet Jesus, when they meet the child and Joseph and Mary, they hear another message. They hear a message from the angel that says, don't go back. Don't go back to King Herod. Change your direction. Go home by another way. And we hear how the angel appears to Joseph. Joseph was called to go in a different direction, to take Mary and Jesus into Egypt to escape Jesus being killed by Herod. He knows his child is in danger, and so he chooses to listen to the angel and go into a different direction. It's time to get up and go. And then he hears the message that it's time to go back to Israel. But he hears another message. He knows that the child's life is still in danger. So instead of going where he thought he was going to go, he chooses to go to another place. I think about this story every time we come to it, which is every year, and it's usually around the end of the year or the beginning of a new year. And I think to myself, how many times we start out a new year thinking we're going one way and something happens that takes us on a different journey or on a different road. And how many of us pay attention to what that message may be? Because our instinct is to stick with what we know. So even though we may have a sense that we should go in a different way or take a different road, many times we kind of fight that message and stay and do exactly what we've already been doing because at least we know that. At least we know that. And sometimes the unknown future is more scary to us than what we're doing now, even if it's not working. And we know in our heads, you know, that doesn't make sense. But it's part of our human nature of letting go and trying to trust what we hear, either the messages of our hearts or the messages we may receive from God. It can be about any number of things, but you and I know that there are those days, and we will have them this year, when where we thought we were going changes with a word, an action, an event. And do we pay attention to where God may be speaking to us in that word, that action, that event, that person who comes into our life? Can we trust that God may be taking us down a different road? And if God takes us down a different road, do we trust that God will be with us on that part of the new journey? Here we are at the end of a year, and we have been spending these months of Advent training our ears to hear the stories of the angels coming and sharing news with Elizabeth and Zechariah and Joseph and Mary and the shepherds and now the Magi. Have we heard the angels speaking to us in a new way this season? Are we willing to commit ourselves to the journey of the new year? And are we willing to let go of what we don't need, whether it's some stuff or whether it's an attitude or a thought? Is there something we need to let go of that we don't need to carry with us on the journey so that our lives can be freed, so that we can embody the messages of hope and peace and joy and love for all people that has come to us in Jesus Christ. So on this last message of our angel series, it's get up and go, hashtag more life. So let us get up and go from this place today and leave those things that weigh us down as we move into the new year with hope and new life. Thanks be to God. Amen.